Hey guys, how's it going? It's Zed for me, and today we're going to be installing the automatic Frunk in our Tesla Model Y. So the process of installing the automatic Frunk in my Tesla Model Y took approximately 2 hours, and that included some videography or, you know, placement of the cameras. So really this job could be done in an hour and a half, and I know that looking at online at least, it looks like the installation job is one of the more involved installations, which it is. I mean, for the first time I've taken out this front panel over here, so it definitely is a more involved type of install than what I'm used to, but overall it really isn't a tough job to do. So I'll take you through the steps I did in order to install this, and just word of warning, the instructions that come with this, this is from Hanshow, the instructions that come with this are pretty poor, but there are multiple videos online which show how to install it, and they're much better because there's a couple of tedious parts that require actually probably video in order to see exactly what's going on. And so first thing that you do is basically take out this entire Frunk liner. The panel over there just pops right out, it's just a bunch of clips. And then there's four screws in order to remove the front tub. So there's one here, and then two under my mat here, which you can see right there and right there. After that, there's just one clip over here underneath this, which is easily taken out with a flathead screwdriver. And then the entire front is exposed, ready for the install. So the main points of this install are swapping out the two struts, one here, into power struts. There are brackets which come with it in order to kind of change the position of one of the ends of the struts. And the reason I think they do this is because the power strut, I believe, is pretty generic. And so instead of creating an entire new strut, all they did was create a bracket which offsets the mounting locations so that you can actually use this strut, the power strut, with this particular car. The installation for the two power struts over here is definitely the most difficult part of this install. In order to get the actual old strut off, you need to have a very small picket tool which allows you to pull this part back in order to pull it out. I didn't have that, so I tried a flathead screwdriver, but it was very difficult to actually get it off. So I kind of forcefully just pulled it off, which it took a lot of strength. I did not break anything, so potentially, you know, for future installers, you can definitely use this as an option, but I would just get one of those picket tools, I'll show it on the screen right now, which allows you to pull this back, makes it easy to take the strut off. Actually, on the other side, instead of actually taking it off because it was so difficult to reach, all I did was put in a wrench there to actually take off the mounting point, which has to be swapped out anyways, and so I just took it all out as one piece together. Oh, this is really important. So after you get one side of the struts out, you have to use a really sophisticated hood prop to make sure that your hood doesn't fall. Ask me how I know. So when it falls, you're gonna need to figure out a way to open up your Frunk again, and definitely use a hood prop so that the hood stays up, because with one side, the strut is not enough to actually hold it up. After doing the struts, you just have to do the front over here, which is the locking mechanism. And so the locking mechanism, putting it together is a little bit of a hassle as well. You have to take off the actual spring. Once you take the spring off, you have to, I guess, mate the two pieces together and then put one of the drawstrings. Essentially, you're just creating extra mechanism for a motor in order to unlatch the hood. All of that is basically tied together with a control unit. This newer control unit is a version 3, which doesn't require a waterproof housing. It's in and of itself already waterproof, and it's just a matter of connecting all of the connections for it to work. One of the things about the controller box is that all the connections are unique, and so there's really no messing it up. I just kind of connected whatever I saw fit, and eventually I was done, and all the connections were correct. This particular version, there is no safety string that goes out to the front tow hook cover, which goes over here. The older versions did have that. I'm not sure if it's necessary, but I'll let you know if I have any problems with the Frunk opening in the future. But the only wire that doesn't get reused is the button that goes right here. So if you guys didn't know, there's a button for you to use your Frunk over here. And when you press that button, now it's connected to the controller. It's not spliced in per se. And so the original connector is no longer used, and now it's just connected to the controller box. I mounted my controller box and basically in the front crash bar, just found a space where all the wires would allow me to fit it. And then the motor, which actually does the hood unlatching, I put where they recommended, which was tucked off to the side. Either way, you just need to find a space that allows you to put your tub back in and mount it securely. So actually on my first try of testing this out, it worked perfectly, and the best part about it was that there was no adjustment that I needed to do for the hood latch, which was something that I was worried about. I had no problems with the fit and finish of this Tesla, so I didn't want the hood alignment to be off. And so after closing it for the first time, I was really checking the alignment side to side, as well as the height from here to here. And luckily, I don't know if it's luck or whatnot, but all the alignment is exactly as it was, and there's absolutely no issues with the alignment of the hood, which was really nice. Supposedly, I think there is a way to open and close it at a faster, slower speed, but currently the speed that it does it at is fine by me. So if you look at it, it takes, I'll try and count it, 1 Mississippi, 2 Mississippi, 3 Mississippi, 4, 5. So essentially about 5 seconds it takes to fully open, and 5 seconds to fully close as well, which for me is plenty fast enough. One of the cool features, I guess, of this one is that it will actually not close on you really hard, and it has, I'll show you what I mean. When you actually close it, if something is in the way, like my arm for example, it won't actually hurt me, I guess. It'll detect it, and it just does, it barely puts any pressure on you, and as you can see, it opens right back up. So I'll just press the button in, which actually doesn't work. So at this point, you know, what do? You just go to the app, or you go inside your car and you just press the button and it just reopens. As you can see on the app here, it detects whether or not the front trunk is open. So as you can see there, it's open. And then when I press to close it again, it'll show that it is closed like that. Now, one thing I want to do test is to see if it doesn't close, whether or not it detects it as still open. So let me take a look. Okay, so it looks like on the app, it shows that it is indeed closed, which is kind of a safety feature problem if you ask me. Let's say you put something in the trunk or the Frunk, and it wasn't able to close all the way. Now you think your hood is closed, or the car thinks the hood is closed, but it actually isn't. So just something to be aware of. Obviously this can then fly up. Just to make sure that it's actually latched before you drive away. I guess one of the cooler parts of using this automatic Frunk is that when you go out to do curbside pickup, you actually don't have to interact with anyone. So it's truly contactless. You could just have them put it in your Frunk, and then you could close it remotely from inside the vehicle. So in the age of COVID, obviously, protecting yourself, protecting your family, and protecting others is really important. So that's just a small feature that I think is really cool about having the automatic Frunk. Obviously, the main parts about it is that most people actually don't use their Frunk. And a big part of the reason, I bet you, is because it's not automatic. You have to press a button, open it yourself, and when you close, you have to close it in, not really in a special way, but you have to be really gentle to make sure that you don't actually bend the hood, because it's made of aluminum. And so having it be automatic definitely makes that easier. So that's basically it for today's video. If you guys have any questions, please leave it in the comments below. Thank you guys for watching. I'm Zed for me, and I'll see you guys in the next one.